the first day of Easter break for Borromeo Seminary, there are three seminarians who decided to hang out that evening and celebrate their freedom. So they got together one night at one of the guys' houses in Cleveland Heights, and they hung out in the back porch smoking cigars and just hanging out. But they wanted to take a little adventure. So they started walking around, went down to University Circle near Case Western Reserve, and they just walked around, started talking and having a good time, enjoying the scenery and the cool air. And then they started talking, and they got very animated and about certain subjects. They were talking about problems of the world and seminary life and misconceptions of what people thought of who seminarians were and many different things. And they were so animated and excited that they thought, you know, maybe other people want to hear this. Maybe this should be, you know, disseminated throughout the internet. So they had an idea. Maybe they could start a podcast to share with other people, to let people know what it's like to be in the seminary, or just talk about their certain ideas or musings of a college seminarian. Welcome to the Buckstar Banter with your hosts, myself, Dominic Gideon,
Mike Bedell,
and Rob Popik.
So, as you heard in the story, we are the three seminarians who are starting this podcast. And we just want to talk about, you know, seminary life, different ideas and musings that we have that are on our minds. So, first, before we get into this stuff, we got to introduce ourselves.
So I'm Mike Bedell. I'm a junior here at Borromeo. I'm from Cuyahoga Falls, went to Cuyahoga Falls High School, a pretty big public school. Cuyahoga Falls is about 40 minutes south of Cleveland, just north of Akron. And I'm really happy to be here. I had a great summer. You'll hear about that in another show. But it's good to be here, good to be back with my brother seminarians, and I'm really looking forward to this year, and looking forward to doing this podcast. I think it's going to be a lot of fun.
Heck yeah. I'm Rob Popik. I'm a sophomore, second year here at Borromeo, and I grew up in a large Catholic homeschooled family, so definitely kind of a drastically different background from these two, to my brothers over here. And yeah, I'm definitely happy to be back, and after a long summer of working, you know, I have been looking forward to getting back in the swing of things and just the routine of seminary life.
I'm Dominic Gideon. I grew up in Cleveland Heights and went to St. Ignatius High School. And, you know, this is my second year. I'm with Robby. Last year was awesome, and the seminary life has been great. But one thing I just want to say is it's good not to be a freshman.
Well, it's even better not to be a freshman. It's better to be an upperclassman, where you sort of have a little bit more responsibility. And here in the back hall, I'm the oldest, so it's kind of like being a senior.
Congratulations. Mm. Yep. I will tell you, though, there is nothing like not being a freshman.
Oh, amen.
Because here at the seminary, like, especially your first couple weeks in seminary, there's a lot of orientation stuff, a lot of, like, you know, just getting you up to speed on just anything under the sun here at the seminary. So it's definitely really nice having, not being in the limelight a little bit, and, like, cause I feel like a lot of the focus is on you when you're the freshman, so we can kind of, you know, fly under the radar a little bit and just, you know, get in our routine and get what we need to get done.
Exactly, yeah. Plus, the fact that the first year of seminary was so different. There's such an adjustment that you had to make.
Absolutely.
And there was so much on your plate, and it was overwhelming. And although it was a very, very blessed year, you know, there's a lot to learn. And it's nice to come in knowing the lay of the land and, like, already having a community of guys that you're tight with, and yeah, coming in with experience.
Right.
One thing I really like about being here in the Diocese of Cleveland is our seminary is connected with the local Jesuit college, John Carroll University.
Go Blue Streaks!
Yeah, and one thing I really like about that is you don't have to take classes with your brother seminarians, and with that, you're able to sort of branch out and develop yourself in a unique way, whether it's through academics, athletics, or clubs and stuff. So why don't you guys talk about what you've done at John Carroll that's sort of unique, that puts you separate from the seminarians, but then also you can bring that back to the house and benefit the community.
Well, personally, academically, I really love writing in English, and hopefully I could make that a part of my vocation in the future. And now, my John Carroll experiences will include a English major in addition to philosophy, which all of us, for the most part, are doing. And also at Carroll, I try to get active. I try to, you know, hang out with... I knew a lot of people coming in from high school, and try to make new friends and get active in certain clubs. Like, I'm in the Fair Trade Club. I did radio last year, which was a lot of fun, so I've been trying to...
Yeah, so we got a little bit of experience here. Mm-hmm. You know what it's like to be on the air.
Exactly. I'm a veteran.
A veteran.
All right, yeah.
Seasoned veteran. Yeah, for me, I think my experience at John Carroll might be a little bit different, because I'm... So growing up, you know, I went to St. Delbert's and Maria on the west side. That's our parish. But I was homeschooled, played a lot of high school sports, though. And so sports, that's like my whole life. That's how I made my friends, my best friends I played soccer with in high school. And so I'm not really the kind of person that just goes out, you know, talks, just strikes up a conversation. I'm no Dominic Gideon.
Yeah,
just, you know,
he's
walks
our social
up
to
anybody and, you know, just starts goofing around, whatever. I'm more of like, you know, I just meet people through activity. So like intramurals, I think I really enjoy doing intramurals at John Carroll, and you know, just going to you know, any of the sports games, soccer games, or we just started doing practicing with the rugby club. So that's been absolutely a blessing, and look forward to see where that will go for sure.
Oh yeah.
For me, I was new. I was a big nerd. But one thing I really developed my nerdiness when it came to foreign languages, and specifically ancient Greek.
New heights of nerdiness.
Yeah, dude. New heights of nerdiness. Like, I'm on a different level now, I guess.
It's
but
nerd major.
I took a couple Greek classes, like ancient Greek language, and I discovered that not only am I pretty good at it, as I really like it. So I really dived into that, and so this semester I'm taking 12 Greek credits in one semester. And that's really, really cool for me, because I'm getting to be a part of the classics department, meet some awesome people there. The classics department is awesome. I love the professors. And it's really offered some great opportunities for me to dive deeper into the scriptures, which are written in Greek, more into the culture of the ancient world. And I think it's a lot of fun just to find your own niche there.
Yeah, I mean, Bedell is a great example of someone who could be very enthusiastic about certain things, especially Greek. You know, living across from him, I get to experience his enthusiasm, and, you know, a lot of times I'll just be hanging out there, especially last year, I'd be in my room, and then across the hall I'd be like, hey, Giddy, guess what? I'm like, what?
That's not what I sound like.
I'll work on it, but, you know, then he just starts talking about some, like, ancient scripture word that actually goes back to certain and all his meaning and all these definitions, and... It's interesting, but...
Yeah, it's not uncommon to walk into the Buckstars, which is our back hall lounge here, and just have Mike Bedell sitting here, like, scribbling, like, you know, Greek, like, a thousand words per minute, and then, like, proceed to tell you for, like, 15 minutes about one word, which is fantastic, but that's not a very uncommon thing to happen back here.
Well, I think it's great to do all that stuff, because...
Indeed it is.
There's such diversity here, whether it's me with Greek or... Dom with his clubs, or Robby with athletics, there's definitely even a wider variety than what we have represented here in the three of us. There's something for everybody here at the seminary, whether it really could be anything, and we all use that to help build up the community and in our own way develop that as our identity.
Right, and I think one thing that is something that I found, so this year at the seminary, a lot of people view, you know, coming to the seminary, or like, say, relatives of mine, and I think you guys can probably attest to this, they hear, oh, you know, you're going to the seminary, like, you got all this going for you, but you're going to go in and just get stripped of your personality, stripped of your desires, your passions, all your aspirations. But that's not really the case at all. I think the seminary, it's we're here to be formed and grow closer to Christ, and to be, yes, stripped of our hopefully our faults, our vices, but it takes our strengths and our desires and our passions and just tries to nurture those so that they all glorify God. And I think that's something that people might not realize, and being here at the seminary, I think it's just a win-win.
Yeah, you can never make a wrong decision by going to the seminary. The stuff you learn here, be it spiritual or philosophical or just how to be a good Catholic guy, you can't make a wrong decision. And one thing I know was a big fear of mine, I'm sure you guys encountered that, is what would it really be like to live at the seminary?
Right.
Is it guys just walking around in cassocks carrying the great work of St. Thomas Aquinas in Latin, just chanting all the time? No, there are guys currently watching...
There's a few of those, but...
are a few, but there are guys watching the Ohio State game right now in the lounge. There are guys who are going to be studying all afternoon. But really, we're all here as guys. I mean, think of a house full of 18 to 25-year-old guys. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Absolutely.
And we have all sorts of sports. We pray all in a community. And all it's not intimidating in the sense that this is not something I could ever get used to. But it's encouraging to see there are guys who have been here for 8 or 9 years and love it.
Yeah, I think our formation here as men and hopefully, God willing, is to become priests is very holistic. It's very focused on forming us as humans, as human beings, as good Catholics. It's really cool because, back in the old days, they didn't really have a sense of holistic formation, so it was kind of just like you studied hard, you followed these strict rules, and you prayed a lot, and that was kind of
right.
Formation. And but now it's completely different under the help of JP2 and a lot of other influential people. So it's good to be in the seminary nowadays. And yeah.
And one thing I would say to a young man thinking about going to the seminary or just contemplating the call of priesthood possibly in their lives is. It's you can't lose coming to the seminary, whether it be for a year, 8 years, you go on to get ordained. You can't lose, because the thing what the seminary does is it forms you to be a better Catholic man. And I think that's especially evident in the college seminary here, in minor seminary. It's forming us to be Christian, Catholic men, striving to be closer to Christ and striving to serve the people of God. So there's even you come to the seminary for 1 year, realize... discern that the priesthood isn't for you, you're a better Catholic man and you're better equipped to go out and evangelize the world, or you keep going all the way through seminary and you discern that, priesthood is what God's calling you to. There's no lose-lose, and I think that's something that has really helped me in my discernment and kind of taken the stress off and helped me to just, place my trust in God and, there's not as much to worry about as people think, I think.
I think, touching on that human formation is super important, like Robby was saying. And it's about being somebody that people can look at and not think that, oh, this guy's like way above me, he's this guy who's only studying, but he's a guy, he's a person first. I mean, first of all, we're sons of the Father, and that means we're human. That means that we have likes and preferences and things we like to do and things we don't like to do. And we can use those here in the seminary to learn from other guys, to learn how to become a Catholic man. But the one thing I really like about being here is seeing everyone at their different levels of formation.
Right.
So there are guys who are about to be ordained deacons. They're about 6 months away from becoming priests. And then there are guys who just got here 3 weeks ago. So you have the entire
Absolutely.
Gamut. And then it's cool to see how I fit in there. Like, I'm looking, okay, I am very different than I was 3 weeks into the seminary freshman year.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I was off the wall, could not be contained. Like, my energy was not...
can I even imagine?
I had stories.
My energy was not directed at all. But now I sort of have an idea of what it means to be here and what it means to live in community and channel your energies in that way. So what about you guys? What have you seen in the last year or so the last year that you guys have seen change? Because I'm sure there's something different just coming in, whether it be your outlook or... an aspect of your faith or what have you.
Well, I mean, coming into the seminary, as I said, it's a big adjustment. And personally, and I think for everybody, you have to go through this mental change. You have to kind of, your outlook has to change on how you live. So, in high school, I had the opportunity to date and stuff like that. And then my schedule was different, my routine. And coming in here, It was a big shock, trying to transition to, you know, this life of, you know, being able to court women to
there's a word for it.
Yeah, you know, a nice old-fashioned term. Or you could say the wheeling mentality. I like that. To a kind of mentality where you need to look at women, all women, as sisters in Christ, which you should always do, but never kind of a way of dating or anything like that.
Yeah, and I would say, so for me, I think my experience, like, transitioning into the seminary is definitely a lot different than, say, Mike, you know, a secular public school, Giddy, a private Catholic school. You know, I was homeschooled my whole life, so it was not as bad in the sense that it's very focused and personal here at the seminary. There's only 30 of us on the Borromeo side, and so it was, like, I guess you could say a little, kind of similar to homeschooling, but really, like, drastically different in that three times a day we're praying this book with,
oh,
you know, seven bookmarkers, and you're flipping through trying to find these pages, like first semester of the seminary with the breviary was, like, it was a struggle, just finding where you're at each day with all the different, you know, saints and feast days, whenever, and I think the breviary was definitely something that, you know, now they have it down, it's fantastic, and it is probably one of the greatest tools to discernment and just enhancing your prayer life. But, and just things like that in, you know, say a regular college kid might not do, or you wouldn't even think about coming in the seminary, but that was a big adjustment for me. But one thing I think is cool that we all come from kind of different, you know, our transitions, maybe we're very different, but one thing I think that helps us all very much is that we're all like the same age, and we're striving for the same goal, which I think is just to be closer to Christ and to know His will. And I think that's something that gives me a lot of encouragement and a lot of clarity in my vocation, my discernment.
Yeah, that oneness of a goal I think is really important, because no matter where you came from, we're all pointing in the same direction.
Right.
So you can look to either side of you and see guys who are very different from you, but take heart in the fact that they all want the same thing as you. And they're all enduring the same struggles. Everyone's having to cope with the same problems in the house. And we're all trying to become men of God. And in the essence, that's what the seminary is making us do. And that's really, I think, where the seminary system wins. Whether it makes a good priest, or whether it makes a good father, or a good religious brother, or a good single man, the seminary wins every time.
Yeah, I mean, so going through formation here is cool, because you get to encounter people with all this different spirituality, with all these different outlooks, while all having the same core Catholic values as you. So that's, like, it challenges you and to look at your faith in a different way that you never thought of before. You know, coming here, I barely knew anything about the old Mass, extraordinary rite of the Mass. So the Mass said in Latin, yeah. So, you know, like, but coming here, you meet all these, like, some traditional people, some people with just very different outlooks, and it challenged me, and other people who very much inspired me in terms of faith, prayer. So that's been really awesome in this time here. So now we're going to end our time in prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to witness our faith and our seminary experience. Please help us and help the listeners grow in faith and know God's will more. Let us preach His word in action and in our dialogue. Let us be enlightened through this time at the seminary, along with our brothers and sisters who are not at the seminary. Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.